What up? Only one song, and with the late bring-ups, what is this Tuesday we got going on here, my man?
Wasn't that a good one?
That's a good one. That's a good one.
That was this song, I think.
Oh,
Break
it was
My
not a good
Stride.
one. Then it was not a good one. I toasty picked it. How you doing, my man?
Doing good. Doing good. Let's see if Aptos crash. Oh shit, he sent me a message.
Wouldn't worry about it if not. From what I've seen in the Aptos world, it's I don't know if it's living up to the hype that it was. I mean, people are still trying to build on it, but that first week FOMO has definitely dropped.
Yeah. Let's see, he's coming. I just sent him the invite. Let's get it. I agree. It has been slowing down for sure. But I don't know, it haven't, like, did it ever pop off? That's the, it never did, dude. There was some, like, the Aptos monkeys, you could have made a bag on those, but other than that, I don't know, dude. I haven't been on so much.
Right.
Hope he would tell us about it.
I still GM, haven't GM, GM. Anything GM. On Aptos.
But by the way, GM. Aptos felt like a hype NFT mint. It minted, and then it died down once everyone sold out. That's how it felt.
Yeah.
Everyone moved on to the next thing already.
It got hyped too fast, dude.
I know. That's what I'm saying. And if you didn't sell on the pump, now you're just bag holding.
Yeah. Oh shit! We gotta announce the winner of the Tokyo Saints as well from the Alpha
wasn't
last
it?
Alpha Tuesday.
I'm assuming it's Meta Tattoo.
Right.
Maybe. Who knows?
Who did that one, Jiraiya?
Jiraiya called Meta Tattoo. Yes.
Yep. I'll take it.
Yeah.
Are you off work today, Odie?
Yes.
What happened there?
First day of the month.
It's like, what happened there? It's your day off. Why are you taking it? Huh? What's weird?
Wait, so you're always off the first day of the month?
No. First day of the month ended on a Tuesday. Alpha Tuesday.
Huh? I'm so confused.
I'm normally off Tuesdays. So the first day of the month ended up on a Tuesday. So it matched up.
I see.
Yes. Some Tuesdays I work when I got stuff going on. That's what.
I see.
Today's Alpha Tuesday.
It is indeed. I contacted also the guy we had on last Aptos. I can't remember his name. Buzzing Boomers. Fuck, what was his name? I feel so bad for not remembering. Goodness. Yes.
Yeah.
So I contacted him and asked him, like, hey, we're going to update everyone on Aptos. Do you want to come on? And he replied, I'm not sure if you're aware. I felt so bad, dude. I even had voice for this. I'm not sure if you're aware, but our project went to shit. So we're going to refund everyone and rebuild. I was like, oh, shit.
That sucks.
Yeah. Poor guys. They got stuck in the hype as well.
Yeah.
I got to check what I sent for time to this Aptos crash guy. Because this time zone is 2 p.m. EST. I'm first.
That's now.
If he's in Europe, he's probably fucked up like me. Because someone tells you 2 p.m. EST, you check your time, and it says 8 p.m. And then it's 7 p.m. the other day. Americans are so weird, dude.
I didn't know that the whole world didn't time change at the same time.
Yeah, that's right. Why is that? Why is it 1 week in between?
I have no idea. Completely throw off the world, I guess.
Is it just Europe or all London? Or, I mean, like certain times, certain places in Europe?
No, every country has a different standard.
So like China then. How is China?
It's like at least in Mexico, it's even an issue inside the country. Like some states will change time, and some states just don't and keep the same time all the year. So it's not standard.
I see.
Well,
I see.
Next year in the United States, we might not have to take daylight savings time. They already passed the bill. They just need to vote on it this year, and we might not have next November. We're not going to have daylight savings. We will stay the Zing.
Ooh, AptCrash is here. How are you doing, man? Welcome.
Yes, what's good, everybody? Sorry, I had to make sure I was connected and everything today.
No worries. Let's see. I'm going to ping the tweet. We can try to do our best to get some people in here. How many are we? 7 so far. I'm so happy Toasty and Sesty are here. The bros, the family is here. Let's lick that thing and see if we can get some people in here. We're going to talk Aptos. Get a sense of the Aptos market. I've been checking it out today to see what has been happening. We also got AptCrash with us. We're going to dive into Aptos Crash, the project. Do you have a, can I call you by name or do you want me to call you Aptos Crash?
Oh, you can just call me Ren.
Ren.
Yes.
Ran, perfect. Welcome. Either way, we're going to start it because we're also a podcast and those guys don't want to listen to us ramble on about time differences all day. They want to listen to the value. Should we wait a little bit with the, what do you think, TK? With the calls from last week, just for you, Ran, we're usually up on Tuesday. That's usually what we do on Tuesday, where everyone gets to make a call, and then we post it, and I can prove that I call this, this guy call this, and then next week we check how much they profited. And last week we did a giveaway as well with this. So the winner is going to get a Tokyo Saints NFT. I would like to see the guys that participated in here first before we go on with that. So maybe we should wait. What do you think?
You can just tell them at the end. Let's dive into the Aptos market and everything and get the podcast started. And at the end, if those guys are here, sweet deal. If not, we'll hook up with them in Discord. Keep it moving, baby.
I'm going to post. I'm going to tweet it and post. I know the winner. I took the snapshots 1 hour ago, like we said, 1 p.m. EST. So I know the winner, but I'm going to give you guys some blue balls. Maybe that's not how you say it. Sorry. All right, guys, let's start it.
All righty then.
I read I tried to check some news for the day. I saw that Dogecoin was pumping, and I saw why Dogecoin was pumping because a little guy called Elon Musk decided to tweet a Doge dog with a Twitter logo on his shirt. So this could be interesting because we know for a fact that Binance invested in Elon, right? And in Twitter. And this guy, if he actually makes Doge some type of payment in Twitter, I'm going to cry, dude. What do you think?
I mean, there's a possibility. The internet and the world loves irony. So if he turns Dogecoin into you can start paying with stuff on Twitter, I mean,
oh, yeah, bro.
That's what beautiful. The world needs. I mean, if you can start buying everyday things with, at all, because that's all it takes is one of these big companies to be like, all right, well, pay for everything in this coin, and to the moon we go.
Let's see. Dogecoin was up like 200% in the last days, just from Elon. I guess it's not maybe not only Elon, but anyway, like even if it's Dogecoin leading the anything that can pump our coins right now, I'm happy for.
It was 6 cents last week, and I think I saw it like at what 14 cents. Something like that.
Yeah, Bob, to something like that.
We'll see. Apart from Dogecoin, we're gonna get into the episode 79 of this thing we call the pod. We're gonna take the temperature on Aptos, as we said in the tweet. It's been a little over a week since we did our first Aptos episode, and like 2 weeks since this chain went live. Since then, I think it has been roughly 69,000 NFT projects launching on this new chain, which is obviously a little over exaggeration, but there has been a lot of ICE and projects on this chain. And I think you're going to have to tell us more about this, Ram, but I guess it's getting harder and harder for projects to get seen in the world of Aptos. But this is just the process of the game, right? Builders will survive, and all these projects that launch because of the hype will probably fade eventually.
What's the current price of Aptos at the moment?
What's the 823?
Okay, so it's been sitting healthy in that 7 to 10 range. So since it's been out a couple of weeks, that's solid.
Yep. Saw it at 7.5, so it's up a little bit. Let's see when it ends up. Yeah, let's get some Aptos discussion going. We're honored by AptCrash, and from what I saw, you guys are obviously on the Aptos blockchain, currently minting and building a crash game with RevShare to the NFT holders. As always, if anyone listening want to come up and share some insights, feel free to come up. But to start it, welcome, Ran. How are you doing this lovely Tuesday?
Doing good. And I appreciate y'all having me here today, you know, to come speak about the project. You know, I've just been on Spaces every day with coffee and crypto, just continually kind of, you know, pushing the movement, what we're doing. Because we are still building. We didn't mint out. I wasn't planning on minting out right away because we don't really need the funds to build. We need the funds more so for the actual function of the game in the future. Obviously it's a crash game, so we'll need a house wallet. So that's basically what majority of the mint funds are pretty much going into the house wallet. We'll have about 10% I'll take out for, you know, artists, the actual team, the dev itself, and to kind of hire on more devs. Doing what I see fit for the community to kind of further itself. But we are planning to be long-term sustainable. We want to kind of have more games on the platform other than just a crash. We're going to kind of evolve it to have, you know, a variety of different games and opportunities that people can play in. Once we get more traction, more people coming in, I'm able to start connecting with some of use our traction to connect with more of the streamers who might want to kind of stream some of our game footage and gameplay. What I'll be doing then is kind of, you know, finding different ways. Maybe we can disperse other, you know, rev share to smaller amounts to different things of that nature, kind of following what the Soul Crash model had, but kind of taking a different route, doing things a little differently. We're going to have some unique features to our platform as well that we're kind of trying to implement. But we are currently, you know, building our dev has basically the frameworks and everything built out for the actual game. We're kind of going through everything about how we want to actually have everything randomized, so that way we get the best, random chance and make it more fair for the actual community. So that way we can, you know, if anybody argues that our site isn't fair, we'll have the actual code to kind of back it up, our, you know, claims and statements and things of that nature. So that's kind of what we're going for. I do have a dev, he's from Mero Labs and he works with Dark Skellies. So he's pretty, pretty chill. He's very, very good at what he does. I do have a dev background a bit, but not as much as he does. So that's why I got him to build a platform. I'm more of just the mover and kind of putting people in places and getting shit done, you know? So that's kind of my vibe. But feel free to ask any questions if you have. Our platform is planning on being done in about 2 weeks. Still talking to the dev, trying to see what day would be best for him to kind of come on. But he wants to kind of have everything like a sneak peek here soon, possibly this week, if not sometime this by the start of next week, and we'll try to get them on a space here so that way we can have like a dev AMA session where you can ask them questions and things of that nature.
I love it. And I've seen you in spaces as well. You're out here grinding. That is the way to go. We're going to dive into AptCrash as well. But first, let's talk some Aptos in general. Tika, have you bought any? I know you were on the very hot on the Aptos whitelist. Have you bought any yet?
I have not. I have been fading the whole thing. My biggest fear is the coin is going to crash. You know, I'm afraid the coin's going to go down to like $2 and it's really going to do something to the ecosystem. So I'm watching very heavily of what's going on, and with the new ecosystem just getting built, the amount of rogues and scams of what's going on over there. Like, there's some serious money to be made, but you got to be careful.
Yeah, and with let's say, like on Aptos, especially right now, you know, there are a lot of new projects and things of that nature. But like, I think this is from speaking with more of my Alpha Collar friends and stuff in the space. They are, you know, they're very heavy. They get profits, you know, they're profit maxi. So they'll go to pretty much any chain they can make profit on. For them, it's more so they kind of got in, you know, they got in on some of those early big plays that, you know, had some solid profit on Aptos. But their mindset was most definitely like, it's a new chain, being very degen, kind of risky. But at the same time, like, I'm just going to buy in if I got whitelist, and pretty much if he only had whitelist only type deal. And then after, he would sell pretty much instantly, or, you know, floor it at once he started to see a pretty much a decent profit for himself. So that was like their mindset, right? Dealing with Aptos projects. But then you have some of them that were, you know, have recently came out with some of their stuff they've been building for a while. So some people kind of stuck around for the long term. But I personally have gotten whitelist for a few, like the Top Sharks. I got into those and, you know, I got burned on those a little bit. So I'm just chilling, kind of seeing if they're still building or not. But yeah, it kind of depends on the project, the people, and what you're looking for in the market too.
There's definitely a extra risk in just a token, apart from the NFTs and the token as well. It's moving faster than these other tokens are doing, and it's a new token, so we don't really know yet. But as from what I've seen, let's say the tech have been holding up. I have been in one mint, only in one mint yet, but it sold out in like 3 seconds. And from what I've heard, I haven't heard any doubts about the chain in general, the tech.
Well, yeah, it actually Aptos uses both languages, I'm pretty sure, from Ethereum and Solana. So that's kind of why, like, as far as a dev perspective, you kind of have a ballpark, like a free roam park you can just kind of go in and have a blast with, because you can use both coding languages, and there's a lot of ways that can go like good and bad. But there's like a lot of fun things that you can kind of implement to your platforms now, and websites and things of that nature, and dApps.
So what's your opinion on this? We had a, like, as I said in the last episode, when we saw all these Aptos projects started launching and the interaction, like, I haven't seen that type of interactions since like this summer when the OK Bears and all of these projects started launching. It was just crazy. I know you have a project on the Aptos chain, but if you try to be like unbiased, what do you think? Is the hype slowing down, or where are we at?
Yeah, I think overall the hype is slowing down. People are starting to be a little bit more cautious about their plays. The people that have made profits, they took the profits already, kind of got into maybe some more blue chips back on Solana, or, you know, whatever chain they were also looking at. I know a few buddies that did that, typically from, you know, their flips on Aptos and went to go get some other projects. So I do think long term there might be some cool things to come to Aptos, obviously, like with every new chain. You know, same thing that happened whenever Solana got its pump, you know, as far as like people coming to Solana, because I had friends that were on there when it was at 250. So, you know, I know how, like, as far as like projects launching and the cycles of how things move. So, like, I think overall we'll see Aptos kind of dip down in hype as far as projects minting every day and you know, things of that nature. But I think what we'll see is a lot more like, you know, kind of same thing happened to Solana. A lot of the projects that were actually building products and had these marketplaces, launch pads, you know, tools, things of that nature. I think we'll see a lot more of those start to come up and show out on Aptos, just because of how easy it is for devs to actually implement certain things or build on top of the chain itself. But I do think it's going to take a lot for Aptos to kind of like sustain itself, in my opinion. I think it's going to take a lot from not only just like the, you know, community NFT side of things, but also from like the crypto and like technical side of things.
Yeah, indeed. And one thing I heard a lot, I don't know if it's only the people that I talk to, but since day one, I've heard that it's just hype and everyone will move on from Aptos and go back to Solana or whatever chain they came from. Of course, like, we're in crypto, I guess this is always a possibility. Anything can happen. But I'm curious what you think about, apart from the thing we're in right now. I see so many, that's the thing that makes me still believe in Aptos in some way, because we see all these people who move to Aptos and some of these utility projects starting to be built, right? So what's your opinion on the, I guess, apart from this hype cycle, the future of Aptos?
In my opinion, I think overall, like you said, like those projects that are still but not the solid utilities are starting to kind of show up. Like I saw one yesterday, or the day before, I think it was like some Aptos rats or something. They were basically like they had built a verification tool for their holders, so like you could get your NFT, and it was like a 3-step verification. So in comparison to like, you know, Matricia or the other ones, you know they use on Solana, it was a pretty quick, easy process, and a lot of people got the roles instantly. So that's kind of why that project pumped and stuff. So, but it was the fact that they had that product to show to the community, I think. So once you start seeing more like projects like that and the hype dies down, you'll start to see like the real like golden or blue chips of Aptos start to pop up. But I think until the hype dies down, we won't really know who's going to be like set in stone on Aptos yet.
Super interesting. Yeah, as we said, we see these builders kind of move. So hopefully they're able to sustain this chain, or at least the NFT side of the Aptos. How come you had the project on Aptos, right? What was your thought process? How did you get into launching a collection on Aptos instead of any other chain?
Yeah, so for me, it was more so like first mover advantage. I've been in space for almost a year now, so I've had like previous experiences working with different teams or like smaller founders, things of that nature, kind of getting my foot wet into like how projects are ran, what goes into the mindset of some of these people that are running these projects. How could I go about running my own? But with Aptos, it was just more so I saw a first mover advantage, and I wanted to take a part of that, considering there's in my lifetime, I'm younger person, so I don't have obviously the life experience of some of these people in the world that are able to say, oh yeah, if I would have gotten early back into like Facebook stocks and stuff like that like way back in the day, like you would probably have been well off. So just trying to be like a first mover, honestly, on the chain and take advantage of the fact that there aren't many gambling or casino meta type of platforms or anything on Aptos. And we obviously seen how the casino meta performed on Solana. It performed really well. A lot of projects had really high floor prices. Communities were pretty positive. Payouts were nice. Because I was in a few of those, casino meta projects and stuff like that early on, getting some of the profit share and the rev share and stuff. So I think, that's kind of like my mindset was just being like a first mover into this and actually building something that will be more long term and actually have some value to the Aptos chain.
This connection between the gambling sites and the NFT space is very funny. We have actually discussed this very in depth in another space, but it makes you think what type of people are in the NFT space right now. It's definitely a lot of people that loves to gamble their money. But speaking on this,
it's in the space for sure.
Yeah, the DJs. I honestly, I've done it myself, though. Especially the Crash game, dude. That is, I fucking love the Crash game.
Yeah, that's my best profits as far as gambling. I turned like, my best play was like 1 week I did a $10 bet one day, and it was like early in the morning. I turned it into like 3 sol, and after that, I turned it into like 35 by the end of like a few hours, so that was the play as far as like doing Crash. But like I've had my bad days, but majority of the time, if you go in with a strategy, you kind of come out pretty positive on the most part. But it's all about how you play and what you do. So, but everybody's different and luck of the draw sometimes. So
it'd be cool to see. I know I actually listened to, I think it was a tweet, or if it was a YouTube video of a guy talking about where they talked about how the gambling, the bigger gambling sites, not in Web3, but in Web2, is doing. They have all this, they basically have a team just checking the players, and then they categorize them on how much they make or how much they lose, because some people always figure out a way to win more than others. So if they win too much, they make them a problem customer, and they try to make them lose, or in some cases, if you do it, they just decline their account from playing, so they have to go on a new account, or just they ban them from the site. And then they also have the losing group, which is their best customers, right? So they make them VIPs and give them a bunch of it could be anything from travels to, I guess some of you have seen this as well, but a bunch of VIP things. You can get a spa weekend, you can get all this type of stuff. So it would be funny to see if people start figuring out the Solana or the crypto gambling sites as well and start making a bunch of problems for the sites.
Yeah, no, and from what I've seen like lately, as far as like the crypto gambling goes, like a lot of the sites are run pretty well. As far as I know, I haven't, you know, I've had any personal issues, with the sites. You know, one time I think I had like an issue with a, what was it like a? I think it was like a withdrawal. Or I think one of the times I was playing Crash or something on the Soul Crash, it had like a delay or something or a lag, and I couldn't cash out or something like at the time during that crash, and I had got like a pretty good multiplier. I just reached out to the team, put in a ticket. They had a ticket system, you know, and basically, you know, that's why I like the way Web3 kind of operates a little bit, because it's like a little bit more direct when you're talking to the teams and founders and things like that, because you can reach out in their Discord. So like that was kind of like you know, like my experience as far as, you know, the gambling. I haven't seen too much of like you said, like of people, you know, taking advantage of the players, whether they're good or bad or anything. If anything, I've seen a lot more players get rewarded from some of these sites. I know some of them are hosting major giveaways this week, stuff like that for players that are betting on higher bets. So they have benefits for people that are putting in more bets or, you know, playing more with larger bets and stuff like that. And then there's still some benefits for the smaller guys too, because I know for Soul Crash, they have a rebate system. So, and essentially, not only them, I know Crash Out and a couple other like other on-chain crash games from different chains have, in a sense, like a rebate system or spin the wheel or giveaway system, in a sense, to where some of the players that play often or play enough, you know, on the site can get rewarded just by playing, you know. So I think that with Web3, that's kind of like the aspect of how some of these people operate on it, which I've seen, which is a good thing, you know, in comparison to some of the Web3 casinos and stuff. I mean, Web2 casinos, sorry.
No, so sounds like we're sitting here promoting gambling. Yes.
Yeah, no, it's not financial.
Okay, go ahead.
So with Aptos just coming out, and I know that Soy is going to be following suit, do you plan on being on there as well? Or is your guys' plan only to stay on Aptos and keep putting different games out there?
Yeah. So our plan, like our actual site won't just host Aptos. It will start off obviously with Aptos, you know, with that being our brand and our name and everything, but we will have other cryptos, you know. I know Sweet's getting ready to launch. I've been kind of keeping an eye on them, you know, as well. I don't know if you guys know a little alpha, you know, sometimes they'd be having airdrops. So I don't know if you guys can still get in my airdrop, but I've been trying to figure out how to get on the airdrop just in case. But yeah, like, that's as far as like Sui goes, but like other cryptos, yeah, we'll definitely put like Sui, you know, Solana, Ethereum. We'll have other opportunities for you to like bet other cryptos. It wouldn't just be Aptos, because of the possibility of like us having other games. You know, I think it will kind of bring a little bit more benefit, because I know some games you can't really play on. There's like a crash for like Polygon, right? You know, some people still hold some Polygon, so I know some people, you know, flip Polygon NFT still to this day, so which is crazy, but you know, and so I know they probably would, you know, want to have, you know, opportunity to play Polygon, you know, on Crash or something, you know. So there's not too many of them out there from that chain, so you know, stuff like that. So there would definitely be opportunities for other cryptos to be implemented and things of that nature. Like I said, our just initial start will just be Aptos, and we'll add more to the platform probably within the first week, most likely.
Good stuff.
How many devs?
Sorry.
How many devs do you guys have on the team so far?
So far, it's a little bit of my dev work, but it's also the team from Mero Labs. I have DevTonic, that's his name. That's kind of like our main in-house dev, but he's pretty well versed. He's worked on a lot of clients' things and like products and projects and stuff. So I brought him on board. And I'll be kind of onboarding more, you know, pretty much more team members with the actual percentage of the mint funds that I'm taking out for the team. So it won't just be him for future purposes, because I want to make sure it's sustainable in the long term. So, yeah, but I'm also taking some extra, you know, courses and furthering my dev skills as well. So that way I can kind of take the reins and operate. If, you know, my devs are ever busy, or if, you know, things go down and my, you know, what, you know, who knows, IRL happens sometimes. So, you know, he works too, IRL. I don't. I have the luxury to where I don't, but he does. So, you know, I like to try to be there. And, you know, if my devs are busy or something comes down IRL, I want to be there to kind of help and fix what's going on.
Let's soon announce the winner of the Tokyo Saints. We got some people joining us. Let's take a couple more questions. Are you, I'm curious, are you the first crash team on Aptos?
Yes, we're pretty much planning to be one of the first ones. Yeah, I'm not sure if any of them I've seen. Actually, there was a few that came out. We were actually the first ones to trademark the name and the account from what I've seen and actually come up with the concept, because when I made the actual product and the project, nobody else was doing a, you know, Aptos or Aptos project or Aptos gambling, you know what I'm saying? So we were pretty much the first to actually like move on that aspect. And I'm hoping for us to just be the one that kind of comes out of the whole spiel of Aptos projects here. So we have the full platform ready. Everything's running smooth. Probably, you know, end up becoming the best one on Aptos. That's my main goal, my main vision for the actual project.
First mover advantage. Perfect. What do you say, TK? Should we announce it? The winner of the Tokyo Saint.
Hell yeah.
All right, let's do it. So for anyone entirely new and wondering what the fuck are we talking about, last Tuesday we had a alpha call spaces so people could come up on stage, name drop a project, and then this an hour ago I followed up on the price increase and price decrease. The one with the best call won a Tokyo Saint NFT. So that is what I'm going to announce right now. We had some profitable calls. We had Adam, who called Blocksmith, 90 up to 95. TK is at D-Gods, 265, now 269. Utes increased a little bit. Ghost Kid increased just minimally, Odi. Lost Soul, you called Soul City Poker, up 7%. But we have a winner. Third place, Adam for calling Blocksmith. Second place, Lost Soul, calling Soul City Poker. First place, Jiraiya. Of course, we're calling Meta Tattoo Club, which has been pumping like crazy. So he called it at, I think, 5 soul, and now it's sitting at 7 something. So up a little over 30%. So he wins a Tokyo Saints NFT. Is he here? No, he's not. So he's going to be happily surprised when he gets tagged in the tweet. Awesome. Cesty, what you have been winning? You have been winning your times in a row. Isn't that enough for you? You had to win this well? All the thumbs down.
Perfect. That's crazy, yeah.
Let's get back into Aptos. What did we talk about? Dude, I remember I had a friend. I need someone to figure this out for me in Web3, how we can do this. On all these Web2 platforms, you have the, when you sign up, you get a bonus, right? So he told me that, just send me some money, I'm going to go place a bet, and then I'm going to give you a bunch of money. So I sent him some money because I trust him. He went, got my bonus. He went on his account and placed a bet against my bet. And in that way, I didn't fully understand it. He got the money out, and I just got a bunch of money for free. So I need someone to figure this out in Web3. Are you going to have any sign-up bonuses on it?
Oh, yeah. Most definitely we'll have a sign-up bonus for most the new players to the site. But what we plan on doing initially too, you know, once our mint funds are pretty much a little bit more stabilized and things of that nature for the house wallet and everything, we have that all set up for you guys to track on the Discord and things of that nature. What we're planning on doing is hosting like essentially like a kind of like a beta night or alpha night, essentially, where some of the players will get to play. We'll kind of give them some Aptos to initially like fund their bets and let them, you know, kind of go at it, kind of stress test the site a little bit. This will kind of be kind of like before we actually fully release the site. That way we can stress test and also reward some of our community members for just being, you know, part of what we're building.
Love it. Let's see if we can crack that. Let's try. What was I going to ask? Yeah, what's the plan with the mint? You've been struggling a little bit, but you're out there grinding in spaces. Are you just going to keep it open?
Yeah. I plan on, as right now, just keeping it open, going on spaces, talking about the project, what we're doing, and kind of just getting organically that way. I don't see it will be a problem once we actually have our platform you know, visuals ready and we have everything sneak peeking. And I think we'll get more traction that way over time. But I'm not, like I said, I'm not bothered by it because, you know, we're not in need of the funds to build, but more so just to actually fund the actual game once it launches type deal.
I see. So even if you were to cut the supply, let's say nothing happens in 3 weeks, you won't have to cut supply. It would still be good to launch the game, right?
Yeah, for sure. Most definitely, we'll be good to launch again if we needed to, or you know, however we needed to maneuver, we could, just because we don't actually need the funds to build out the product, and more so, like I said, the funds are just literally house wallet and paying off and hiring new team members. That's pretty much it's very simple of how our funds will be broken up. Nothing too crazy.
Would be a good rep share if you were to cut the supply now for the people that I'm into.
Yeah, most definitely. We'll have you know, once we have more of our like things stabilized and we have like, you know, things flowing, we'll have other opportunities and events probably where we'll have some kind of cool burn or deflationary mechanism overall to kind of take down the supply a little bit. I've been thinking about it recently, like looking at some deflationary models.
Support from AptCrash. Are you trading? You said you minted a little bit in the Aptos community.
Yeah. I'm actually, I'm very like, you know, kind of in tune with the projects that launched, you know, and the ones that are already prepping for launch. Try to get whitelist for some of them. Obviously, it's hard, you know, unless you're like an influencer. It's a lot harder sometimes. So, but yeah, just I try to get in on whitelist if I can, if it's something I'm passionate about, something I like. You know, if I'm able to get in, I'll get in. If not, I'm one of those traders where I can chill back and I don't mind if I miss out on something. But whenever I get in on something, normally it's a profit. So I have a pretty good profit ratio. So, you know, with the way I trade and everything.
So here's what you do for the whitelist. This is what I tell our community. You tell them to come on the pod, and I'll make sure to negotiate a whitelist for you and some other people. So what's the I know the Apto Mingos, is that the biggest product, right?
Yeah, them right now, and Aptos Monkeys. Rubber has a lot of hype too, but I don't know, they've been building for a while. They have a lot of hype. It's just that I can tell a lot of their hype, majority of these Aptos projects, you know, that aren't or haven't been around for a while, they definitely have like botted hype. So I don't know if it's going to be a good mint. But I think, you know, with what I've seen, people posting videos and they've made cutouts at home, you know, IRL stuff, participating in those community events. I think they'll perform well as well. Pretty good on the chain because of the hype they have. So if you're all looking for like some Aptos Alpha, if you can get in on Bruh Bears, or if you have a buddy that has one, I think that might be a solid quick flip if you're looking for something to profit off of kind of instantly.
I think Aptos Monkeys. Was that they're pumped like crazy?
Yeah. They're pumped pretty hard. They've been building since July. I looked on their Twitter and everything. They've been around since July talking about Aptos and their community.
Oh, damn. That is well deserved. I don't know, but then they took a gamble going on Aptos and it paid off.
Yeah, for sure. They had that. The thing was, is like, I think they were already on the site listed and like getting marketed by Topaz, just because they were one of those first few projects. And Topaz, I was in a space with them. That's kind of what they said they were looking for, like any projects or people that were building pre, just for like anybody who's like looking at the launch pad or anything like that for Topaz or any of the other marketplaces. They're kind of right now, they're taking things slow. They, you know, they're only minting projects that have been out for quite a while or been on the chain for a while, and then slowly expanding to the ones that are newer. But priority for them is the projects that were around for a long time. And they're planning on launching like 3 to 2 mints per week instead of like an influx of just random mints back to back to back. So their launch pad doesn't get like compiled with like, you know, some of the scammier projects or people that are, you know, might not have the right intention for their launch pad, things of that nature. But that's what I've heard from their spaces and stuff. So just a little alpha for any builders out there that might be looking at the chain or things of that nature.
So what's the next biggest one? Is that Bra Bears? Is that the one?
Yeah, yeah, that's the one with a good bit of hype. Today I know Moon Otters minted. I think they're essentially like Moon Birds, but on the Aptos, and they're otters. But I think they're the same premise or same concept. But they're building like a launch pad and some other cool stuff with their community. But that was another hype mint that's actually going on today.
I haven't seen that. Gotta check it out. What was the name?
I'm pretty sure it's Moon Otters. Let me double check. I'm very far here.
Moon Otters.
Yeah. Otters. Yeah. Just Moon Otters.
There's definitely some interesting projects going on Aptos. I listened to the Aptos Mingos guy in Spaces, and he was amazing. Can't remember. Do you know? Like, what they have an upcoming collection as well, right? Aptos Mingos.
I'm not too sure on their community. Because like they were one of those mints I didn't really hear about until they minted, you know. But they got a strong community, obviously, because it was a free mint, and anytime it's a free mint, especially, it's, you know, the community is a little bit more geared to help out the project and push it and talk about it and things of that nature. So I know they might have some more stuff in the pipe works, you know, with the way they launched and their model. Of how they launched and things.
Yeah, free mint, the pump too. I think they were up to like 150. That's nuts. I've been seeing all the stories from the Blocksmith chats for all the people who sold way too early. They had whitelist for this thing, but they sold way, way too early. Do we have any tickets? Do you have any more questions? The listeners have any question for the Aptos guys or anything on Aptos you want to discuss in general?
For anybody that is listening, going to Aptos, what's something that you would recommend? What's a piece of advice? Maybe something that's maybe a little different or something that you know that has helped you along the way?
Yeah, with Aptos, a lot of these projects, especially like I've done this on Solana too. Like, don't be afraid to like reach out to the team accounts or actually reach out to the main account. See if you can get an interaction from the founder, the team, somebody who's hosting the social media, you know, whatever. And if you can't get an answer there, I say pop in the Discord and just see the vibes. Ask a question, put in a ticket. That's usually how I do it. If I just don't even feel like wasting time trying to like ping them in the chat, I'll just go in the put a ticket. Hey guys, I'm just trying to chat, learn more, a little bit about the project. Is there any place I can go read about it? You know, stuff like that. But yeah, definitely take it like slow as far as looking into projects. And then when you find ones, you just kind of got that gut feeling, or you just feel really confident in, you read about their white paper, you kind of went through everything, or you just kind of just feel like it's going to be something good. Definitely, I'd just say, you know, kind of go. I usually go with the flow. This is just more so like me. It's not financial advice, but like, you know, that's kind of like my mindset. Like, I'll just see what is the vibe. If it's something that looks sustainable over time, I might give it a deeper dive. If I like it, you know, I'll go into it. You know, I probably won't put all my eggs in one basket, but I will get like maybe two or three, you know, and get out on two or the other two, and keep that one for the, if it goes up, you know.
That you're also involved in the community so we can get some advices all us Aptos rookies.
Yeah, the Aptos, they're pretty responsive, like a lot of the founders and stuff, so that's why I say try to reach out to them in the Discords right now if you can and stuff, or on the Twitters, because you might get a response because they're, from what I've seen, the founders have been a little bit more responsive and active.
Is there any project? We're definitely going to do, I think we'll do more Aptos. We're moving on so many chains. Is there any project you would see on the pod? I haven't spoken to any Aptos project apart from you and Buzzin' Boomers, the one we talked to last week. Who would you want to see?
You're asking me, correct?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. I heard yesterday in Coffee and Crypto, we had, I don't know if you've ever heard of Aptos. I think it's just Aptos Turtles. I got to see there. Let me check my DMs. Yeah, Aptos Turtles. I'm supposed to be kind of talking with them most likely today, later today, kind of chatting with about their project. They had a pretty unique utility. I thought it was pretty interesting. Kind of reminded me of Oak Paradise and how they did the sub DAOs. But they're doing it in the sense that the sub-DAOs will kind of run themselves and their own investments as a community in those sub-DAOs. And essentially what you'll do, it's almost like a hedge fund NFT project, essentially, you know. And essentially what, you know, each one of the DAOs will have a profit loss type report at a certain period to show off how well the DAOs have performed, you know, how many trades have they made in the profit, stuff like that. But it was pretty interesting. If you guys look for another project to pull aboard and ask questions, I think they were a solid project to talk to. They have a larger supply than us. They're about 4,000 right now, and I think they were in the space. We were talking to them. Some people brought up bringing up more because they like a lot. So some of the sentiment towards them was probably increasing their supply, shorting their price a little bit more on the front end, but having a larger supply of maybe 10K and doing a more degen price, kind of like 0.5 Aptos or something. But I was going to talk a little bit more about the founder today in a private chat to kind of see if he plans on doing that, because we might kind of some of our team members onboarded to help them out, expand their collection if they need to, and things of that nature. But they're a pretty cool project that I heard yesterday. In that space that I was in yesterday, it was a little bit more of like a kind of had a Shark Tank vibe. So they got asked some pretty harsh questions, and he was able to respond pretty well to those. So you know, that's kind of was definitely like checking them out.
Aptos Turtles, check it out. Yeah, would love to have some more Aptos spaces and good people like you coming to tell us. Solana Degens.
Yeah, no problem. I know everybody here is familiar with Oak Paradise, so that's why I give that comparison, because they have like a sub-DAO model. It's just that they're not doing it for a casino. It's just more so like trading NFTs in general for each DAO.
Super interesting. Let's see if we can get them on. Aptos Crash, is there anything? Maybe I can ask DK, Odie, and Peter. Do you have anything you wanted to discuss today that we haven't talked about? Don't think so. Then I give the mic to you, Ren.
Yeah, no.
To give us, I'm just give a quick. You know, there is not so much people here right now, but we're also on all these streaming platforms, right? So, to anyone looking at Mint and yeah, just curious, what would you say? Ren? Ren, are you with us?
Oh, can you hear me? I'm sorry. I kind of zoned out there.
No, I was just asking before we round this off, for anyone listening to this, not here right now, if they're listening to this, or if they're here right now, I just said it because we don't have that many listeners, but to anyone listening to this, what would you tell them about your Mint? Why should they go and buy AptCrash?
Oh, yeah. So for our Mint, essentially, I don't know if you guys have seen the success, crash games have had on other chains or just in general. But in comparison, you know, like I go off statistics and stuff. So if you look at the statistics of how it performed, crash performed on Solana, I think their crash got up to like, I want to say like a double, it was a double digit floor around 30, maybe 40 range on their NFTs per NFT. And that was because obviously the rev share that's involved. So that kind of, you know, helps the floor, but also just the fact that platform was ready. Once the platform was ready, things were ready and running smoothly. So I think, you know, once we get more sneak peeks and everything ready, we'll have a lot more hype. So, you know, you pretty much, you have the early advantage right now of us being not as hyped up, not as talked about pretty much, I guess you could say. And, you know, that's kind of my mindset behind it. We're only at 5 Aptos per AppCrash NFC. It is, like I said, on public right now. Feel free to grab one. Our supply is pretty limited at 888 supply. So yeah, I think it'll be a good opportunity to add some rev share for you guys. What we're planning in the future is kind of long term. So we do have a really good long term vision, and you know, I just kind of can't wait to have the people that are aboard and ready for the ride.
Love it. Good stuff. Let's see if you get any mints off the spaces. Perfect. Let's round it off. thank you so much for coming on and telling us a little bit more about, giving us an update on Aptos and telling us AptCrash.
Almost definitely, man. Anytime you guys wanna, you know, want any questions or if you ever need more Aptos or anything, just you know, you got my DM, so you can just DM me. You know, if you ever want to talk about projects or find out more projects to talk to, I'm more than willing to help.
Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Thanks, guys. Thanks, everyone, coming on and spending their time to listen to us, as always. And anyone listening to this in any other place, hope you learned something today. I did indeed get a little bit updated on Aptos and AptCrash. TK, did you learn anything? Or are you still fading Aptos?
I wouldn't say I'm fading Aptos. I'm waiting to strategically jump in and buy the top. I don't like to buy the bottom. As you know, I'm a green candle buyer, my man. I like to buy once things have settled down and then run. It's more of my area. So if Aptos doesn't go to 2, I'll buy, you know, at 25, 30. That'll probably be my entry.
But let's see. TK, please tweet anything when you start buying so us early adopters can sell.
Oh, I will let you know when the top signal has purchased. Don't you worry.
Good stuff. Tomorrow we're going to have Miss T NFT, which is a game they're building, a ecosystem, a little bit about the game they're building. And we're also going to have Beyond Clouds, which is, hey, they've actually been on before, but they have hired a bunch of new people and wanted to come give us an update on everything happening in that world. So we're going to listen to them tomorrow as well. It's going to be good. I don't know what the theme will be, but either way, it's going to be packed, packed spaces with two upcoming Solana collections. So excited for that. Otherwise, make sure you follow AptCrash. At AptCrash. Anyone listening to this? Make sure you follow the pod if you like to listen to us talk to projects and TK buying the top. We're also sponsored by Hyperlaunch, who is building a permissionless launchpad for anyone to launch your NFT collection without writing a single line of code. And I'm pretty sure it's coming on Aptos. I want to give a date. It's coming on Aptos. And all other big chains as well. So we'll try to make it super simple for anyone to launch their collection, even though you're not an experienced developer. Perfect. All right. Guys, thank you so much again. Until next time, have a great evening. Bye, guys.
Peace. You guys have a good one.
Thank you.
See you. Bye. Waking up to ash and dust, I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, the checking out on the prison.